Campaign update. Elizabeth's trip through the South. Posted on March 22nd by Roger Lau, campaign manager. I've got a few updates for you and some great photos to share from the campaign trail. Elizabeth went on a swing through the South earlier this week. 3 days, three states, three town hall style events, and lots of barbecue with three kinds of okra, fried, stewed, and pickled. First stop, Memphis, Tennessee on Sunday. Elizabeth met with housing advocates to hear what kind of support the community needs and talk about our new plan to address our country's affordable housing crisis. At an organizing event, Elizabeth said she's spending as much time on the road as possible, not just in a small handful of states, because she's running to be the president of all of the United States of America. On Monday, we headed to the Mississippi Delta in Cleveland and Greenville. Elizabeth met with local Mississippi leaders and advocates and heard about the region's severe housing crisis. She talked about her comprehensive plan to address our national housing crisis and how she's fighting to make sure every community gets the resources they need and everyone can find a decent place to live. Later on Monday, Elizabeth knocked it out of the park at our live CNN hall in Jackson, Mississippi. There were too many highlights to count, but one of them was her powerful personal story of how her mother's minimum wage job at Sears saved their family after her father's heart attack. Watch it here if you haven't yet. A fun behind-the-scenes fact for you. Elizabeth asked me to make sure that the lights would be on in the audience during the town hall. She wanted to see everyone's faces, every smile, every tear, every nod, and keep it a two-way conversation. On Tuesday, Elizabeth went to Selma, Alabama, and visited Brown's Chapel and the Edmund Pettus Bridge with Representative Terry Sewell, places with incredible legacies of people coming together and fighting for civil rights. Elizabeth talked about how we've got to repeal every single racist voter suppression law, pass a constitutional amendment to guarantee the right to vote, and go even further to make sure everyone's vote counts equally by replacing the Electoral College with a national popular vote. That way, it won't be so rare, especially in the general election, for presidential candidates to go to Mississippi, Tennessee, and Alabama and ask for everyone's votes. We wrapped up the trip with an organizing event in Birmingham. Just like Elizabeth does after all these events, she took pictures and talked with everybody who lined up for a photo. One woman came up, wrapped her arms around Elizabeth, thanked her for being there, and said, "A little hope goes a long way. I'm so proud of how we're going around the country and building our grassroots movement, face to face, person to person. But it takes serious resources, and it's only possible because of supporters like you. Will you make a contribution right now to own a piece of our campaign? See you on the road." Thank you.